control of temperature process using on-off control. Today we are going to see closed loop control of a temperature process using on-off control. For that, what we are going to do is we are going to control a water bath. We want to control the water bath at say 70 degrees centigrade. We want to control the water bath at 70 degrees centigrade. For that, initially the water bath will be at room temperature. We will use a heater to raise the temperature to 70 degrees centigrade. The heater works on 230 volt 50 hertz single phase power supply. So we need a transmitter to measure this temperature of this water bath. For that we will use a RTD, will be placed inside this water bath. PT 100 will be used to sense the temperature of that water bath. So it should be signal conditioned. For that a bridge will be constructed. With each arm has 100 ohm. Across one of the arms, this RTD will be connected. This RTD is connected across one of the arms. This RTD is connected. So we have to give a power supply. A 5 volt DC power supply will be connected to this, and two terminals are taken across the opposite corners of this. So bridge output is available across this. The resistance, how the PT100 works, the resistance varies according to temperature. At 0 degree centigrade, the resistance of this RTD is 100 ohm PT100. At 100 degree centigrade, the resistance at 100 degree centigrade, resistance of RTD equal to R naught 1 plus 0.0038 multiplied by temperature, that is the resistance of the RTD. It is 100 1 plus 0.0038 multiplied by 100 degree centigrade. So it is 138. Since the formula is R naught into 1 plus alpha naught multiplied by T. Alpha naught for the RTD is 0.0038, and therefore we will get 138 ohm. We will get what is the expected output of this bridge at the room temperature and at 100 degree centigrade, let us check. Let us assume that room temperature is about 30 degree centigrade. For 30 degree centigrade, the RTD resistance at 30 degree centigrade, R30 equal to 100 multiplied by 1 plus 0.0038 multiplied by 30, it comes around 111.4 ohm. So what is the output voltage if we give the bridge is supplied with 5 volt? What is the output voltage for 100 degree centigrade and 30 degree centigrade? Let us check. If it is 138, the bridge output is across AB, we have to find the voltage. VAB equal to 138, because this end is grounded. Therefore, this voltage across this point is 138 divided by sum of these two resistances, that is 100 plus 138, minus the potential at this point. At this point is 2.5 volt because both are 100 ohms, that's why it's 2.5 volt, that is 100 divided by 100 plus 100 multiplied by 5, that is equal to 0.4 volts we will get. Similarly, this is for 100 degree centigrade, 100 degree centigrade. At 30 degree centigrade, the same way if you obtain, then 111.4 divided by 111.4 plus 100 minus 100 upon 100 plus 100 multiplied by 5 equal to 0.138 volts. Let us assume that we are going to design a transmitter for the range 0 degree centigrade to 100 degree centigrade. At 0 degree centigrade, the output of the bridge is 0 volts. Therefore, the bridge output varies from 0 volt to 0.4 volt, 0 volt to 0.4 volt. Now, let us design a transmitter which will give 5 volt corresponds to 100 degree centigrade and 0 volt corresponds to 0 degree centigrade. For that, what is the gain required for this bridge, we have to check. So, the output voltage is 0.4 and 0. The input span is 0 to, the input span is, input span is 0 to 0.4, output span is 0 to 5 volt. Therefore, gain of the circuit must be 5 minus 0 divided by 0.4 minus 0, that is 5 by 0.4, 5 by 0.4 equal to 12,500, 0.4 equal to 12,000, check 12.5, the gain must be 12.5. We need an amplifier of 12.5. So any bridge should be given to differential amplifier, that we know. So we have to give this output to the differential amplifier. The feedback resistance must be, if it is 1K, input resistance means feedback resistance must be 12.5 times, therefore 12.5K feedback resistance. Here also it is 12.5K. So the output here we will get 0 to 5 volt as temperature varies from 0 to 100 degree centigrade. So here we will get 0 to 5 volt. Now you want to use this signal to control this heater by using an on-off controller. For that, we will use a relay to turn on a power supply. So that relay is made up of coil is made up of coil, and the relay will be turned on and off. So 230 volt, 50 hertz single phase power supply is given here. This end is connected to neutral. So if the relay is turned on, it will give power supply to this heater. For that, a 12 volt relay is used. This 12 volt has to be given here. One end is grounded, one end is grounded. Other end we need give 12 volt power supply here. For that, when and all this heater has to be turned on, suppose the set point is 3 volt. 3 volt means 5 volt corresponds to 100 degree centigrade. For 70 degree we want to control. 70 degree means 3.5 volt corresponds to 70 degree centigrade. Where this voltage, this 0 to 5 volt, this transmitter output exceeds 3.5 volt, this heater should be turned off. Whenever it is below 3.5 volt, this heater should be turned on. That way we have to design the controller, that is on-off controller. whenever this transmitter output exceeds 3.5 volt, we have to turn it off. Whenever it falls below 3.5 volt, we have to turn the transmitter on. For that we can design a on off controller that will control the so we need a comparator here acts as a on off controller. So it will compare both values. It is given to inverting terminal. Another inverting terminal we are putting a pot. The pot is connected to +5 volt. So by adjusting this we can give 3.5 volt here. 3.5 volt here. If we give 3.5 volt, means if the process variable, that is transmitter output, is above 3.5, the output becomes -12, because the open loop op amp gets +12 and -12 as its power supply. That's why either it will go to +12 or -12. If positive terminal is higher than negative terminal, it goes to +12. If negative terminal is higher than positive terminal, it goes to -12. So if the cross variable exceeds 3.5 volt, it will be turned to -12. If it is less than 3.5, this point is, this is connected to 3.5 volt through this part. Therefore, if the temperature, let us assume that temperature is about room temperature initially, 30 degree centigrade, means the transmitter output is 0.138 volt. So it is amplified to 12.5 times. What is that output of the transmitter for 30 degree centigrade? 0.138 multiplied by 12.5. At 30 degree centigrade, the output of the transmitter is 0.138 multiplied by 12.5. It is 1.725 voltage. So the initially, let us assume that the water bath is at 30 degree centigrade. Therefore, the transmitter output is 1.725 volt. This is very much greater than this 3.5 volt, that is set point. The set point is 3.5 volt. The process variable is 1.725. That's why the output of this open loop op amp drives to -12. Initially, the output of this op amp is driven to -12. This -12 has to be plus 12, because the plus terminal, non-inverting terminal is higher than the inverting terminal. That's why the open loop op amp will driven to +12 volt. This +12 volt has to be used to turn on the heater. For that we will use a transistor to turn on this relay. The relay is 12 volt relay with 200 ohm resistance. Coil resistance is about 200 ohm. Therefore, the current required is 12 volt coil, 200 ohm resistance. Therefore, current required is 0.6 milliampere. 60 milliampere. Am I correct? 12 by 200 ohm, 12 volt by 200 ohm, 60 milliampere. 60 milliampere current is required to turn on this coil. So, if when the 12 volt is available here, means the current through this transistor must be 60 milliampere. Therefore, what is the base resistance required? That is RB required, we have to calculate. The transistor used is NPN transistor DC SL100. We are going to use SL100. Its beta is 99. Its beta is 99. Yes, its beta is 99. Beta equal to 99 for SL100. We need 60 milliampere to turn on the relay. Therefore, what is the base current required to drive a collector current of 60 milliampere? We know that IC equal to beta times IB. Therefore, IB equal to IC on beta, that is equal to 60 milliampere on 99, say 100. So 0.6 milliampere is required. 0.6 milliampere is required. Therefore, IB equal to 0.6 milliampere. To get 0.6 milliampere, the voltage V equal to 12 volt. Therefore, RB equal to 12 divided by 0.6 equal to how much? 0.6 milliampere. Therefore, 20 into 10 power 3 ohm, 20 kilo ohm is required. Therefore, the base resistance equal to 20 kilo ohm. If you put then current through this collector will be, through this collector will be 60 milliampere. Suppose this process variable, let us assume that initially it is at 30 degree centigrade, that is why this turn on this relay, and now it dissipates heat, this heater, that is why whatever the temperature gradually increases, as soon as it exceeds 70 degree centigrade, the transmitter output exceeds 3.5 volt, then suddenly the output of this open loop op amp becomes minus 12. So minus 12 means it will open, this transistor will open, that is why the relay will turn off and there is no power supply to the coil. Whenever the temperature falls below 70 degree, then again the transmitter output also falls below 3.5, again it will be turned on. If you do this experiment, what will happen? Initially it is at 30 degree centigrade, the set point is 70 degree centigrade. So initially the heater will be turned on and it gradually it increases, as soon as it just crosses 70 degree it will be turned on. Because of inertia there will be a slight increase, then it starts falling. Whenever it just falls below 3.5 volt, that is 70 degree centigrade, again heater will be turned on, again it will move up and again it will fall. So it will oscillate around the set point. That we will check through hardware. The beaker, we are taking a water bath, and PT100 is used. This is the PT100 to sense the temperature, and a heater. This is a heater. It works on 230 volt single phase power supply. This heater is connected to the power supply through this relay. This relay will work. This relay will work on 12 volt. Its resistance is about 200 ohm. This relay is connected. One end of this coil should be connected to collector. The other end should be connected to plus 12 volt, so that whenever the transmitter output is less than 3.5 volt, automatically the relay will be turned on. This is SL100, that will turn on this relay. This SL100, base of this SL100 is connected through RB to this op amp. This is the open loop op amp. It compares the transmitter output and this set point. Set point is given by this part. One end of the part is connected to 5 volt, another fixed end is connected to ground. The mobile arm is connected to plus inverting terminal of this op amp. Inverting terminal is connected to output of this amplifier, differential amplifier. So the differential amplifier gives the process variable. The bridge is here. one of the arms is this RTD is connected to one of the arms of this bridge. This is the arrangement for this on-off controller. Now, before doing the experiment, we have to calibrate the RTD. We are taking this thermometer as a standard. By using this thermometer, we are going to calibrate. So now we are going to put this controller in open loop. That is, the output of this amplifier is not connected to this open loop amplifier. That is, the PV is not connected. That's why it is in open loop. Now we have to turn on the heater. To turn on the heater, the 12 volt power supply will be directly given to that relay, so that this will be turned on. So the power supply to the heater can be turned on and off while noting down the reading. For 30 degree centigrade, we have to turn off. Better you can turn off and you note down the readings for 30 degree centigrade. Similarly, up to 100 degree centigrade, you can note down for all temperature, and the corresponding transmitter output can be noted down. Then you have a calibrated chart for temperature versus voltage. This can be used to set the temperature. Here we got for 70 degree centigrade, we got 3.61 volt. So we have to fix the voltage, the set point, by using this part, the voltage across this 3.6 volts is fixed for 70 degree centigrade. 3.1 is fixed for 70 degree centigrade. Now the set point can be given to pin number 3, that is non-inverting terminal of this. Now it is turned on. Temperature starts increasing till it reach 3.5. Till it reaches 3.5. Till it reach 3.5 volt, the relay will be turned on. Now it is under turned on. Let us check how long it is on. The processor will be, now temperature is about 55 degree centigrade. இது கிடைக்கலையா?
எஸ் சார்.
இந்த குச்சி சார், now this relay is turned off. It overshoots up to 3.73. Overshoot is up to 3.75, 76, 77. Now we can notice the overshoot. Even 3.8, almost 75 degrees centigrade. So it remains off till it is above 3.5 volt. That is, the water bath is above 70 degree centigrade. That's why it is it remains turned off. Gradually temperature will decrease and pass below 3.5. Again the relay will be turned on.